This is City Talk 105.9.
Lads, thank you for coming in. Tennis playing brothers and involved in an event at Wavertree Tennis Centre all this week. It's on behalf of Northern Vision alongside Liverpool Hope University, the Aegon Junior International. And it's a busy event. It's been running from Saturday. It's running till the end of this week as well. LiverpoolTennisFoundation.org.uk has got all the details. But Ken, briefly, it's about getting young people playing tennis for a bit of fun, but also for a bit of competition as well.
Yeah, it's fantastic that Liverpool's got a competition like this. It was something that's not been done before, so it's great for people to come down and have a look at what the talent is like of British tennis players and players across the world who've come in to play the event.
The more indoor tennis centres there is in Liverpool, the more chance people are going to carry on from the summer, watching Wimbledon and playing throughout the year. Everyone can get involved throughout the year, and it's good for the young ones to go in the winter instead of staying outdoors.
I was going to say, and having a period of time now, and I know quite a few people who play tennis, and it's got to the stage now where the ball sits a little bit heavy because it's getting a little bit wet if they're playing outdoors, and it's a little bit cold, mm-hmm. and the nights are drawing as well. Presumably having something like this event, which is happening end of November time, it's kind of saying, you know what, the tennis season doesn't stop. Although, yeah. you know, you might have had the World Tour Finals at the O2, you can carry on playing, and you can carry on playing all winter.
Yeah, of course, because I'm sure the young ones have been watching the O2 finals, and they'll be raring to go, so there's no point in stopping the season there. They'll progress and keep on playing throughout the December period, and then hopefully be ready for the start of the season in January.
When you were sort of starting playing, Ken, were you up against the British weather as much as anything? Because presumably the lads that you would meet on tour would be coming from nations like, be it Spain or Argentina, and had the opportunity to be playing outdoors 12 months a year.
Yeah, I mean, Great Britain as a country is very much at a disadvantage because of the weather. But you have to take into consideration there are other countries in the world who've got great tennis players, Sweden, Germany. They've got cold climates, and they do very well. So there's no reason why we can't do well. We've just got to make the most of what we've got. We have good summers now. And the indoor season is quite long, you know. It does run from probably September through till April. So we can, as a professional tennis player, we can make the most of the indoor tennis. There are players across the world who get to play outdoor every day of the year, never see rain, players in Miami, Florida, south of Spain, and they do have an advantage. But we have an advantage over them because when we play indoor, it's to our advantage because we practice indoor. Tennis is becoming more of the speed of the courts in all surfaces are becoming very similar. So if you can be able to play tennis at a very high standard on one surface, you tend to be able to be good on all surfaces now, unlike it was back in the 80s when different speeds meant a different style of play. So now it's one of them things, if you can become good on indoor surface or the outdoor surface, it's very similar.
Neil, past couple of times we've been on, you've been talking about your travels, obviously the pair mm-hmm. of you travelling together now and going far and wide. Is there anything that you've sort of seen abroad or any experiences that you've had or maybe speaking to other players about their development and how they sort of grew up in tennis and you've thought, we're missing a trick in the UK. That's something that we should be doing here. Is there anything that British tennis needs to be focusing on that maybe other players have had and have benefited from?
I'm not too sure, really. Me and Ken went to America to get a better understanding of tennis. I didn't really play tournaments at a younger age, like the tournament at Wavertree, the ITF circuit. So I went to America, played a lot of matches over there and got mentally tough, which got me ready for the pro circuit, which I started in January. So a lot of everyone's different, really. It depends what type of the setup there is in the country. But the LTA, they do a great job with what they do and with bringing up young players. They have a Roehampton, which is the National Tennis Centre. They bring a lot of players through that way. But me and Ken went a different way, but we're getting backing from the LTA a little bit now. And it's good for us to be recognised by them.
So it's about competitive tennis. Neil talks about, you know, playing that in America, having tournaments and competitions, presumably against decent opposition as well.
Yeah, I mean, the way I see it, the more time you spend on court, a lot of the time, the better you become. The problem at times is with us playing indoor tennis, it costs money to obviously use an indoor tennis court. The other players who play outdoor can join a local club and play there all year round. They could be playing 3-4 hours a day, basically for £100 a year, when we would have to pay £10-12 an hour for 1 hour's court time. And it's very difficult for parents to fund that, as well as the coach, as well as balls, and as well as travel to other tournaments. So for us, we are at a disadvantage in that regard. But if we can make tennis a cheap sport so that players can play 3-4 hours a day, if that's what they want to do, they have a better chance of being able to understand how to play matches better, how to compete in singles and doubles. Physically, they can work harder. They can understand the game better. And that's an area that I think we could improve on.
This is City Talk 105.9.